Hey there, cats and kitties. I am the Blues Man, Johnny Blues, and this video is intended to be a video response to my good buddy on YouTube, Labyrinth35, who posted a video asking the overall question, is there too much Sherlock Holmes going on at the moment? And I watched his video and I listened to kind of his reasoning about why he feels that way, and I thought I'd comment through a video response since I can't post comments or reply to them, and, you know, with my thoughts, what my interpretation of that is. And one thing I want to point out right away is I am a thorough Sherlockian. I've read the entirety of the Holmes canon as written by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle a couple times over. A few stories I've read 5 or 6 times, almost 10 times. So, you know, I'm a thorough fan of Sherlock Holmes. And for me, you know, from the get-go, my knee-jerk reaction is to say, there's never enough Sherlock Holmes, frankly. But getting beyond that aspect of it, trying to be more objective, I have to say, like, you know, I think the best allusion you made in your video, Labyrinth 35, was to Batman, talking about the Dark Knight Returns and the recently announced in any case, Ian McKellen starring feature, Mr. Holmes, that I'm uber excited about. I mean, the idea that it might take place in the 1930s or 40s or what have you really excites me because, you know, it kind of harkens back to the Basil Rathbone film series, which was a much more modern spin on Sherlock Holmes. I haven't seen any of those as yet, planning to eventually someday. But I like that aesthetic, you know, keeping in line with Sherlock Holmes, you know, being the detective that he was in the late 1900s, which harkens, you know, pretty closely to his age range in the novels and novellas and stuff like that. And then building off of it and putting it in a slightly more modern setting, but he's going to be aged, so, you know, maybe not up to snuff physically as he is mentally, and that, you know, presents a lot of great challenges. Like you said, kind of akin to The Dark Knight Returns. Now, where I think it was a very apt sort of cross-reference, talking about Batman, is because I feel like it's a Batman kind of thing, you know? You really can't cast a stone without hitting something that Batman is in these days, whether it's the comics, whether it's animated films, whether it's video games or, you know, movies and such like that. There is almost no time to stop and take a breath before you run into the next incarnation of Batman. And I feel like Sherlock Holmes has a little ways to go before he's reached that, you know, that point. But the great thing about both of those characters is the interpretations are all different. In your video, you've mentioned the Benedict Cumberbatch Sherlock series, which I have yet to see as well as the Americanized version, Elementary, which I have yet to see as well. And, you know, the great thing about it is they are really unrelated. They are completely different interpretations of the character, as well as the Guy Ritchie, you know, Robert Downey Jr. films, another ultimately different take of Sherlock Holmes. And that's the great appeal to this thing, the cross-cultural appeal, is that, you know, it's taking off from the same base, but they're really all different kinds of things, very much like all the different interpretations of Batman. We're going to have Ben Affleck playing Batman in the upcoming, you know, Batman vs. Superman film, and then Justice League to follow. This follows on Christopher Nolan's take, which followed on, you know, the Joel Schumacher, Tim Burton take, which we didn't see Batman since the 60s with Adam West and all that kind of stuff. And so there's something for everybody when it comes to Sherlock Holmes. And we're talking about a very intellectual and just really cool character that bridges, at least in the Guy Ritchie films, you know, you have action-adventure going on, as well as that logistical mentality, all that kind of stuff. And with the Benedict Cumberbatch series, there's more of the eccentricity from what I understand. And so, I mean, it's a little bit of everything, you know. So I think to answer the question, is there too much Sherlock Holmes going on? I don't think so, because apart from all the different incarnations that we're talking about, there's also a length of time spread between each of them, between the movies and between the series. And, you know, both series aren't necessarily airing at the same time. So, I mean, I don't think there's too much of it at the moment. I think there's the risk of that happening, but for me personally, I don't really think that there is too much of it, and, you know, I would actually like to see more. I'd like to get my hands on more Sherlock Holmes stuff, the Elementary series and the Cumberbatch series and stuff like that, because I feel like, for me personally, going back to what I said at the beginning of the video, It's never enough for me. So that's pretty much my thoughts, and I'd love to hear from everyone in the comments below who watches this video, if you're a Sherlock Holmes fan or not, whether you think there's too much of it going on, you know, oversaturating the market or threatening to, whether in the UK, the US, or the world abroad. And yeah, otherwise, I hope this video finds you well, and I'll catch you all later. Peace.